Chapter 3, A Little of History. Jeff Sutherland. While in the 1960s, workers suffered from the tyranny of the ex-chiefs and the rigid and inflexible working methods, Jeff Sutherland, the inventor of Scrum, was engaged in piloting combat aircrafts in the Vietnam War. Jeff, during this time in the Army, burned into his mindset the following values. The value of trust in the team, because otherwise you were dead. The value of self-organized and multidisciplinary teams. Jeff was used to seeing fully autonomous special mission commands that contained a doctor, a sniper, an interpreter, an explosives expert, etc. These commands could undertake any type of mission because they contained all the necessary specialists to carry it out. They were given the vision of what it was needed to be done. They self-organized and acted autonomously. The value of the continuous inspection. Jeff met a fighter pilot instructor who was the best in his category. This instructor was obsessed with the OODA principle, which consisted in observing, orienting, deciding, and acting. First, the situation was observed by pilots. Then they were oriented towards an objective. Then the tactics to be followed were decided, and finally, action was taken. This simple principle is what caused American fighters to have far fewer casualties than Russian MiG fighters, piloted by Koreans and Vietnamese, despite the fact that Russian aircrafts, MiG, were faster and more maneuverable. The cause of this fact was slow to meet. In the end, they realized that the key was that the American pilots had more visibility from their cockpits than the Vietnamese or Korean pilots, so they could apply OODA iteratively. The Americans saw their enemies before, oriented their attack, decided a tactic and acted. Then they repeated the process again, iteratively, while the Vietnamese, shorter and in large cockpits, prepared for Russian pilots who were taller, did not know where the attacks came from, so they couldn't practice OODA, as they couldn't observe the situation. Upon returning from the front, Jeff graduated in statistics from Stanford University and went to work in the University Laboratory of Artificial Intelligence. From there, he went on to teach mathematics in the Air Force. Then he did a course in biomeasurements at the Medical School of Colorado and received his doctorate in biomeasurements. All this effort made him realize that human communities are complex adaptive systems, as cell communities are. Every time you try to change an organization, people get lost and become resistant to change. But then everything comes to an equilibrium, just as it happens to cells. The Reagan administration made a major cut in the research, so Jeff was laid off and had to change area. He was hired by Midcontinent, a software company that valued his knowledge in statistics. There Jeff found himself with an environment X of the 70s, where people were treated disrespectfully, there was no trust, and where a lot of time was spent executing unproductive tasks. Jeff, who had experienced the value of trust in the team, came across dysfunctional teams, where members didn't involve in the decisions, so they couldn't commit to them. Neither was the context created towards observe, orient, decide, and act, OODA, you remember. In contrast, an initial plan was set, and the project was sticking to that plan with earmuffs, as if the plan was more important than the response to the change. And, to Jeff's astonishment, he saw how the specialists trenched themselves into hindered departments and communicated with the rest of the world through documentation, being insensitive to the project and unaware to the commitment to move it forward. The teams couldn't carry out the projects themselves, so they required the collaboration of those hindered departments that I mentioned. The result was projects that got stuck because of the internal bureaucracy of the companies. Thanks to the excellence that Jeff showed, he got a position as vice president at Midcontinent, so he was able to test a change plan. Together with his collaborators, he designed a new methodology that applied all the values and principles that he had brought from the war. That methodology made a lot of emphasis on teamwork, so they gave it the name of Scrum, melee in French, which is the phase of rugby where players come together to design the game strategy. Other privileged minds detected the same problems and devised ways to develop software in a more efficient way, such as Kent Beck, who devised extreme programming, known as XP. Jeff, Kent, and other software gurus drafted the Agile Manifesto, the starting point of the Agile Revolution, which restored values to the business world. The Agile Manifesto. The Agile Manifesto was written by Jeff Sutherland, along with Martin Fowler, Ken Schwaber, Kent Beck, and other brilliant minds of the time. It's true that all of them came from the software world, and it's also true that the title of this book is Scrum for Non-Techies, but we have to give the software world the origin of this teamwork methodology. What many software companies experienced in the 90s was a true chaos. Unmotivated teams. Projects that didn't end. Not finishing a project meant that it had been delayed twice as much as estimated, or cost twice as much as budgeted. Projects that didn't deliver what the client requested. Money loss, use of great efforts in completely unproductive tasks that did not add any value. That is precisely the scenario that both Jeff and the rest of the signatories of the Agile Manifesto found. This group of visionaries met on February 17, 2001, in Snowbird, Utah, to try to put common sense to this situation. The Agile Manifesto they wrote is a compendium of four values and 12 principles, and they constitute the support of Agile methodologies. Any methodology that applies these values and principles is an Agile methodology. Scrum applies them, so Scrum is one of the Agile methodologies that exist. XP mentioned above would be another one. And how are the values of the principles different? Values are a moral code, while principles are laws or rules that are followed to achieve a purpose. For example, all thieves lack principles because they don't follow the law or rule of respecting the property of others. However, even thieves have values because they follow the moral code of not stealing from each other. Scrum is based on agile values and principles, and we'll see them in detail in the following chapters.